Hi Scorpio, it's Sloane Rhodes here with your love and romance reading for April 2017. This is for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, and Rising. I'm going to be drawing three cards from the Archangel Power Tarot, three cards from the Tarot of Sexual Magic, and one card from the Angel Answers Oracle deck by Doreen Virtue. And then, Scorpio, I'm just reminding all signs that my podcast is up. It's free and available on iTunes and SoundCloud. So if you are interested in hearing more on spirituality, metaphysics, healing, transformation, you can take a listen there. I've got links here as well as beneath the video. So, Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising. Let's get started with your reading. Love and Romance for April 2017. Okay, here we go. Perspective. Six of Michael. Two of Michael. And the Page of Michael under the deck here. Show you the cards as I see them. You do have major arcana energy here, so influencing this a little bit more heavily with the Six of Michael and the Two of Michael. I love to see this in the center because it does indicate that you are leaving something behind after probably a period of feeling kind of stuck with that perspective card. And you're leaving something behind, but you're going towards something where you're not even quite ready to make a decision on something. You're allowing a little bit of time to pass, a little bit of stasis during this time period for there to be a balancing of a situation, balancing of karma, possibly within a connection or just within yourself. On the Page of Michael under the deck, it looks like there could be communication coming in or just fresh consciousness coming in where you might be like, what? What is that? But then it's ultimately for your best and highest good here. I like to see that perspective card too. It does indicate some spiritual awakenings, a new way of looking at a situation, or at least you're being encouraged to do so. The more that you can create a change in perspective around your love life, it's going to lead you to something, to leaving something behind that has been on your mind, that you've been contemplating rather heavily. And you're going to continue this period of sort of non-action regarding whatever that may be. I'll get additional cards as we go along, Scorpio. That's just kind of a snapshot of what we're looking at here. I'm going to get three cards from the Tarot of Sexual Magic for you. Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising. King of Wands. The High Priestess right in the center goes nicely with that perspective card in terms of a spiritual awakening. And the Nine of Wands. And the Empress under the deck. So I'll show you the cards as I see them, Scorpio. We have the King of Wands, we have the High Priestess, Major Arcana right in the center, and we have the Nine of Wands right here as well. This is very much, and you're so in tune with your emotions and the emotions of others. You have a wonderful intuition, Scorpio. So it looks like right here in the center, and especially around sexuality and in the bedroom, you're going to be really trusting your intuition, going within, knowing what is the key to someone else's heart here. There could be, this is the King of Wands. In this deck, I don't really look at it in terms of corresponding to certain signs, astrological signs. But it is a Wands energy, and I'm really, really drawn to that yellow, so it could be a Leo involved here, I'm just going to say, but it doesn't have to be, okay? And it's about that connection, connecting with another. But you're changing your perspective on it, and I think you know what makes that person tick. But you're withholding a little bit, it feels like. We also have that Empress energy under the deck. You know, it's available to you to take action, but for some reason, I really do feel like you're withholding a little bit here. You're not quite ready to do something in love. Let me get a card from the Angel Answers deck. Yeah, I'm just getting the sense, like even with this card, like just intuitively just looking at the imagery with his hand over her mouth, and you know, you're not quite ready to either to hear what she has to say, but there's passion involved, But you're just not quite, you're not quite there yet, Scorpio. In a lot of different ways, let's say. Because you're changing your perspective. You're having a spiritual awakening. You're understanding yourself more completely as a spiritual being. And, you know, you do have the gift, Scorpio, of being able to intuit others, to read emotions very nicely, very readily. And it may be that there's been a pattern in the past where you used it in a way as a weapon in love, let's say. Not for everyone, but for some of you. It's, you know, we all use our gifts in love in whichever way it works best to our best advantage, right? But it looks like maybe you're shifting your perspective on the way that you've been in love. And you're, you know, the text of this card, there's a better way. Pause for reflection and insight. Dare to be different. You are leaving something behind, a situation that's been troubling you, but you're not going anywhere in a hurry. Let's put it that way. Opportunity. You're really waiting for that right opportunity. So when you do take action, Scorpio, it's going to feel like this. Like, yes, the time is right. And this is not the time. Like, you're still weighing things. You're allowing things to settle. I don't know what that means for you. I'm going to get additional cards in terms of the specifics, but that's kind of like how it's feeling here. Let me get some additional cards on the Six of Michael. What is it that she's leaving behind here? King of Gabriel. Again, I have to say now, because we have two King of Wands, it could be a fire sign, could be a Leo involved here. And it's about the wheel, things moving forward, new beginnings, end of delays. The spiritual awakening, spiritual card of spiritual, you know, this and this together, you definitely are going deeper and deeper into your spiritual nature. To where it's unavoidable. You really can't avoid it anymore. Scorpio is here for you. And that's where you're taking some time. You know, you're wanting to adjust things before you leap into a partnership in which you don't feel completely ready, you know, for that next mind-body-spirit connection. You may already have that as well, but there's always deepening and levels that you can go into here. But this leaving something behind, it is about this King of Gabriel. It could be a fire sign. It doesn't have to be. I did get the Leo hit, but from, you know, again, it's a general reading. And the likely outcome is forward momentum, divine timing, right? Karma being balanced, divine timing comes in. So it's all at play here. You are likely to move forward even more quickly regarding this Six of Michael having to do with this King of Gabriel, either someone that you're leaving behind or someone that you're going towards. And when it happens, it's going to happen in the perfect timing. The opportunity, again, will feel more like this. You won't have to work for it, Scorpio. You don't have to worry about it. It's going to happen for you, but just settle in to your high priestess energy. You're changing your perspective. You're having a spiritual awakening. You're being called towards something greater. There is something better waiting for you. Do what you know is right, a spiritual quest. You're very much here around your spirituality here. And the Empress, again, this, she manifests from this place where it feels like this, right? When you're in tune, you know, whenever you try to manifest something from all this like fear and worry and anxiety, and it takes you so long to get there. But when you're like in the flow and divine timing comes in and you trust in your intuition as you're being encouraged to do so, Scorpio, with this high priestess energy, when it happens, when the opportunity arises, it's just like, whoo, it just takes you that much further. It's like you're being glided there. I feel it. Okay, let me see what else I want to get for you here. Okay, so let me get two cards on. It's feeling kind of complete for me, actually, but let me get two cards on the Two of Michael. Epiphany. It's like the Hermit card. And the Page of Ariel, needing a little push to get going, which makes complete sense. Four of Gabriel under that. So this Two of Michael, it is about that hermit energy, right? Spiritual epiphanies, joy through spiritual growth, be a light to others, answers that come through meditation. Like, you're not ready to make anything crazy happen right now. You're waiting for a divine timing. You're waiting for signs from the universe. You're waiting till your intuition tells you it's right and true. And then you're going to need a little push to get going. Even then, you're a little hesitant. And that's okay. But what, you know, ultimately it's leading to something joyful and celebratory, which is really, really nice. So be patient with yourself, Scorpio. And I really think it would be wonderful if you can take the time to praise yourself for the deep spiritual work that you've been doing, for the spiritual insights that you've been integrating more and more. Because, you know, you're working with a lot of divine feminine type of energy, personified here with the High Priestess. And the divine feminine energy, as you know, we all hold, regardless of masculine body or feminine body, we hold divine masculine, divine feminine in equal measure, as you know, Scorpio. And so the divine feminine grows and expands through that beautiful praise, and the divine masculine grows and expands through challenge, you know. And so right now, with all this divine feminine energy, the more that you can praise yourself and say, yay, look at me, I'm doing a good job, you know, and even though I may be alone or I may feel a little isolated, it's for a reason, and it's for me, for my greatest good, so that I can incorporate these spiritual understandings that I'm learning, so that I can be a light to others. So good for me, you know, that kind of energy. The more that you can do that, it just helps that divine feminine, your intuition, expand and grow even more and more powerfully, which will be really nice for you. Okay, I'm going to get one more card. I'm going to get it from the magical unicorns, I think, because they're magical. We're dealing with all this sort of magical spiritual energy here. It seems like it'd be fun. Remember, you're waiting for this opportunity. You're waiting to take action once this feels right to you. And there is a magical opportunity coming for you. Maybe not in April, but it could be. Again, these energies are going to be different in everyone's lives, but they don't just start in April and end in April, as you know. They flow into April and they flow into May. So if you're single, be patient and kind and loving towards yourself. And if you are already partnered, same is true. And don't try to push your partner to do anything, or don't try to make things happen. You're just going to rock the boat unnecessarily. Things are shifting and moving anyway, in a good way, in a way that we would perceive as good anyway, here, leaving something behind, the light at the end of the tunnel. But it's not going to happen through your pushing energy. It's going to happen through you being open and surrendered to the way things are now. With the knowledge and the faith and the wisdom that things are changing for the better. You know, it's like that seed that's growing under the earth. You can't see it. You can't see it growing, but you know that come spring it's going to pop out. Love from your parents. Oh, no matter what, your mother and father love you as much as they can. Well, for some of you, that's going to feel very poignant. And for others of you, in a more general sense, I do kind of like this this idea of, during this time of sort of time out, of spiritual understandings, of changing your perspective, you may be asked to look at the dynamic between your mother and father and see how that plays out in your own life, right? You're changing your perspective. So it may be that there was a very traditional or maybe not a traditional relationship between your parents, or it may be that, you know, they stayed together but they weren't in love, or they were madly in love but they never got married. You know, and so it may be that during this time period you're being asked to look at that dynamic and how it affects you in love, in romance. So okay, there you go, Scorpio. I hope you found that helpful. I wish you much love as always, and I will see you on the next video or at your private reading or possibly over at the podcast. Till then.